Hi, this video is for teachers who are working with their students to construct a historical narrative. In this example, we will be looking at the narrative utilized in days 6 and 7 of Unit 3, which is based on the Unit 3 assessment from Passport to Social Studies. Day 6 is dedicated to introducing the elements and rationale of historical narratives, and day 7 is where the students will deconstruct 2 sample narratives and ultimately create one of their own, based on the decade of the 1860s and really drawing on information from the lessons preceding this one. That being said, the skills and expectations included in this overview are applicable to other assignments as well. Just imagine doing it with other content. So the objective for day 6, which is the first day of this lesson, is for students to walk away knowing the unique traits and of historical narratives and what sets them apart from other types of writing that they've seen. And this will be achieved by having them do a double read of the text writing historical narrative. And as you can see in this lesson, the first reading requires them to identify information pertaining to the definition, to the rationale, and to different elements that compose a historical narrative. And the second reading is when they are going to engage in the say something strategy. For my own students, I anticipate them never having constructed a piece of writing like this before, so I would definitely conduct a brief check for understanding between the first and the second readings, just to answer any questions they have or to clarify anything that they might need explained better. For instance, I would ask students to reflect on their initial impressions on how a historical narrative is similar to other types of fictional narrative writing that they've done in other classes, like their ELA class, but also how it's different from writing that they've done in their history classes up until this point. And I do want my students to be aware of the commonalities that exist between fictional narrative writing and this type of narrative writing, because it would likely increase their comfort and confidence moving forward. However, I would stress to them that there are significant differences, and that's gonna be one of the main challenges that they face doing this for the first time. And addressing this before the second read would kind of give them a little more context as they're reading it. And also it would give them a preview of the wrap-up question that they're going to consider on slide 10. The second day of this lesson, which is day 7, and I will jump down to the objective right here on slide 14, is for students to apply their understanding of historical narratives to break down 2 historical narratives. The first would be modeled by the teacher. The second they would do independently, and ultimately use all of this knowledge to create a historical narrative of their own about the 1860s. And this lesson, and I'm gonna skip to it right here, this is slide 17. This lesson starts with the students activating their prior knowledge from the previous lesson about what a historical narrative is, the differences that exist between historical narratives and fictional narratives, and some of the elements of historical narratives that they got from that first reading. And it would be really great if it was possible to record their responses to these 3 prompts and create like a student-generated checklist that they can then use later as they are constructing one of their own for the first time. And this can be done on sites such as Padlet or using built-in features if you're using a platform such as Nearpod or Pear Deck. And anticipating the difficulties of my own students, I would take steps to ensure that they were aware of the following components before moving forward. And if I open the original text from the first day, writing historical narrative, I would definitely make sure that they're aware of what it means to construct the plot, define moments of action, and which of the historical participants they really want to focus on. So going back to the slide deck, I'm going to jump down one slide. Here's 18. Here's where we see the instructions for the teacher-led model and the 4 components of historical narratives that the students are going to analyze. The deconstructing a historical narrative graphic organizer, which is also in Teach Hub, it is right here. It is a great organizer to really break down and identify the parts of the 2 model texts. And again, just on my own students, I know it would be very beneficial to them if I took the time out ahead of time to really explain and give examples of what we mean by historical participants, connectives and transitions, themes, issues and concepts, and historical thinking. And also knowing that they're going to ultimately create one of their own, I would also point out to them, like in the models we're going to look at once together and once they're going to do it independently, that each one of these is only about 200 words in length. And I'm going to stress to them that means the authors of these really had to be selective in what they chose to include and exclude as they were creating them. So I'm now going to head back to the slide deck. And if we look to slide 19 now, this is where the students are going to be directed as far as the directions for the model that they're going to do with the teacher. And this is where they're going to work through deconstructing this first text using the top half of the graphic organizer. And the text itself is available as a PDF, but it's also been embedded into these slides. And I'm going to jump down to slide 27, where now this is where the students are going to be doing it again on their own. And they're going to be deconstructing it using the bottom half of the graphic organizer. And this time it's for a text entitled "An Era of Competing Populist Movements." After finishing their independent work where they deconstructed that second narrative, the students are going to be asked to reflect on two questions, which are going to be on slides 35 and 36. So I'm going to jump down to them. And the first question is about how they can use that second text to serve as a model for the one that they're going to write themselves. And before moving on to the next question, I would remind students that one of the options for their plot construction for the historical narrative that they're going to make, and again, you can see this in the first text that they read on the first day, one of the options for their plot construction is progress and decline. And I would again remind students that in the lessons that they've done leading up to this, this has kind of been the theme that they've seen over and over again. So before moving on to that last question, I would have them go back and look at their work from days 1 through 5. And then take a look at the question that they see in slide 36, which is, with what event are you going to start the first paragraph of your own narrative? And once they're done with this question and they're really ready to start constructing theirs on their own, I would just advise them one last time to reference that class-generated checklist that we made at the introduction activity at the beginning of this class.